Hello viewers, welcome back to our YouTube channel Don Bosco School Tinsukia. Now we'll discuss some formula of trigonometry. Sine 90 degree minus a, we know that different trigonometric ratios are sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, cosec theta. Now some formula here we can see that sine 90 degree minus a, that equal to cos a. Then cos 90 degree minus a equal to sine a. So this is just opposite of first one. First and second, they are opposite of each other. Then tan 90 degree minus a, that equal to cot a, and cot 90 degree minus a equal to tan a. So first two are opposite to each other, then third and fourth, they are also opposite to each other. Tan 90 degree minus a gives cot a, and cot 90 degree minus a, that gives tan a. Then next one is sec 90 degree minus a. Sec 90 degree minus a, that gives us cosec a, and cosec 90 degree minus a, that gives us sec a. So fifth one and sixth one, they are also opposite to each other. So if we know this formula, we can solve some problems. Suppose our question is evaluate sine 18 degree divided by cos 72 degree. What we will do, you see, between numerator and denominator, anyone will write as a difference of 90 degree and a particular number, so that the difference should give 18 or 72. Suppose one we want to keep same, say denominator will keep same, will not do anything with denominator, then all the work will have to do with numerator. So denominator let us keep same, cos 72 degree it will remain same, and this 18, sine 18 degree, we'll write it as sine. Can we write 18 as 90 minus 72 degree? 90 minus 72, if we subtract 72 from 19, what shall we get? You see, 10 minus 2 gives 8, then 8 minus 7, that will give us 1. So altogether 18. So 18 can be written as 90 minus 72. Let me to repeat once again, between numerator and denominator, one of the angles will change, other one will remain same. Here I have kept the denominator same, and I have changed the numerators, this 18 degree angle. 18 I have written as difference of 90, and we have to find the particular number which on subtracting from 90 we can get this value, which is 18. So here it is 72. So this trigonometric ratio, it will remain same, it will not change. So sine will remain as sine, only 18 we have written as 90 minus 72, and denominator cos 72 degree we have kept it same. So this equal to, now sine 90 degree minus a, so here 72 degree means our a. So which formula can we apply? We can apply this first formula, that sine 90 degree minus a equal to cos a. Sine 90 degree minus a equal to cos a. So we'll write cos, and what is the value of a here? Value of a is how much? It is 72. Here not written a, but in place of a we can see it is 72 degree. In denominator it will remain same, cos 72 degree. And if we observe numerator and denominator, we can see that they are same, so they can be cancelled and we are left with 1. So 1 is the answer. So the main thing which you have to remember here, between numerator and denominator, any one you can change and other one you have to keep same. This numerator, if you want to keep same, then sine 18 degree it will remain same in numerator, and in place of cos 72 degree we will have to write as cos 90 degree minus 18 degree. Both if you change, we will not able to solve the problem. So any one we have to change, and here what I have changed, I have changed only the numerator. 18 I have written as 90 degree minus 72 degree. So 90 degree minus 72 degree, that gives us 18 degree. Then in the following line I could able to write sine 90 degree minus a, sine 90 degree minus a is equal to cos a. So this trigonometric ratio sine is replaced by cos, and our a's value is here 72 degree. Then numerator and denominator, they are same, so they are cancelled, and we are left with just 1. Let us take one more question. Question is this one, tan 35 degree, same question, evaluate tan 35 degree, tan 60 degree, tan 55 degree, tan 30 degree. We can see among these trigonometric ratios, no operation is given. No operation given, given, that means multiplication operation is there. Let us write it once again here on top. 10, 35 degree, then 10, 60 degree, then 10, 55 degree, and lastly 10, 30 degree. 10, 30 degree. So like that previous sum, here once again, this first one and second one, these two angles will change, and remaining two angles will keep them same, will not change. We'll just write them same. So 10, 35 degree, 10 let it remain as 10, 35 degree, we'll try to write 35 degree as a difference of 90 degree and another number. So what will be the other number, which on subtracting from 90 we can get 35? Yes, it is 55 degree. So 90 minus 55, 10 minus 5, that will give us 5, then 9 will become 8, 8 minus 5, that will give 3. So 35 degree can be written as 90 degree minus 55 degree. Always we have to write here 90 degree only, not any other number. You cannot write 100 degree, you cannot write 80 degree, etc. Because in our formula here, all are 90 degree written. So we will write the given angle as a difference of 90 degree and the other number. So 10, 35 degree we have written as 10, 90 degree minus 55 degree. Similarly 10, 60 degree, 10, 60 degree we will write as 10, 90 degree minus 30 degree, 90 minus 30, that will give us 60 degree. And the last two trigonometric ratios let us keep same. So all our into is there. So 10, 55 degree, then 10, 30 degree. Now this one, 10, 90 degree minus 55 degree. So it is 10, 90 degree minus A. So which formula shall we use? This formula number 3. 10, 90 degree minus A, that gives us cot A. 10, 90 degree minus A, that gives us cot A. So 10 will become now cot, and our angle will be our A. So in place of 10, 90 degree minus A, it will be cot A. A means how much here? It is 55 degree. Cot 55 degree. Into here also between these two 10, there is multiplication operation. Again 10, 90 degree minus A, 10, 90 degree minus A equal to cot A. So 10 will become now cot, and A, angle A is how much? It is 30 degree. And other two angles, the other two trigonometric ratios, they will remain same. That is 10, 55 degree and 10, 30 degree. Now cot 55 degree, there is one relation between cot and 10 also. Cot, it is the reciprocal of 10. Cot is the reciprocal of 10. So cot theta we can write as 1 by 10 theta. So cot 55 degree, that can be written as 1 by 10 55 degree. 1 by 10 55 degree. Mind the words, that cot, it is the reciprocal of 10, or 10, it is the reciprocal of cot. So cot 55 degree can be written as 1 by 10 55 degree into. Similarly, cot 30 degree can be written as 1 by 10 30 degree. 1 by 10 30 degree into remaining two trigonometric ratios, just keep them same. 10 55 into 10 30 degree. So 10 55 degree in denominator and 10 55 degree from numerator, they are cancelled. Again 10 30 degree from denominator and 10 30 degree from numerator, they are also cancelled. So we are left with 1. 1 is the answer. So if we remember this formula, we can solve many problems. Similar problems we can solve. Now we'll do another problem. We'll take another question. Let us take question is, if 10A equal to cot B, if 10 a equal to cot b, then prove that a plus b equal to 90 degree. Prove that a plus b equal to 90 degree. So we are given 10 a equal to cot b, and we have to prove a plus b equal to 90 degree. So we will start our solution from this thing. 10 a equal to cot b. 10 a equal to cot b. Now 10 a. In few minutes ago we saw that 10 90 degree minus a, that equal to cot a, or cot 90 degree minus a equal to 10 a. Cot 90 degree minus a equal to 10 a. Cot 90 degree minus a. So this 10 a we can write as cot 90 degree minus a. This 10 a can be written as cot 90 degree minus a. Just few minutes ago only you have written this formula. If you check it, you can get from there that cot 90 degree minus a equal to 10 a. So in place of this 10 a, we can write now cot 90 degree minus a is equal to right hand side cot b. Let it remain same, cot b. Now left hand side trigonometric ratio cot and right hand side trigonometric ratio cot, these two cots can be cancelled from left hand side and right hand side, and we will be left with 90 degree minus a. 90 degree minus a is equal to right hand side, it is b. Now minus a will end to other side. On sending minus a to other side, we will get 90 degree equal to b plus a. We are asked to prove that a plus b equal to 90 degree. So here we have got 90 degree equal to b plus a. We can write it from reverse side also. Therefore, a plus b equal to 90 degree. Proved. Now we'll discuss how to find different angles of different trigonometric ratios. Different angles of different trigonometric ratios. How to make that table? Sine different trigonometric ratios: sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, and cosec. We are going to learn the technique by which we can find the values of different trigonometric ratios: sine, cos, tan, cot, then sec and cosec. Zero degree, then 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, and 90 degree. Sine 0 degree how much, sine 30 degree how much, 45 degree how much, 60 degree how much, 90 degree how much. So these things we are going to find now. So for this, sine's value, if we remember, sine 0 degrees value, sine 30 degrees value, sine 45 degree, sine 60 degree, and sine 90 degree. If we remember these 5 values, then rest values we can made ourselves within 30 seconds. Now I am going to teach you this technique, how we can do so. So sine 0 degrees value is 0, 0, sine 30 degree half, sine 45 degree 1 by root 2, sine 60 degree it is root 3 by 2, and sine 90 degree it is 1. So we have to remember only these values. These 5 values of sine, if we remember, then rest table we can fill up within 30 seconds. Sine 0 degree it is 0, sine 30 degree half, sine 45 degree 1 by root 2, sine 60 degree root 3 by 2, and sine 90 degree it is 1. For getting the value of cos, we will do this cross. This last one will come at first and first one will go at last. So 1 will come here and 0 will go there. This 45 degrees middle one, it will remain same in its own place. And between 30 degree and 60 degree again you cross. So root 3 by 2 will come here, and half will take the place of 60 degree. So see, so easily we have got cos 0 degree is 1, cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2, cos 45 degree 1 by root 2, cos 60 degree it is 1 by 2, and cos 90 degree it is 0. Then 10, for getting the value of tan 0 degree, we will have to divide sin 0 degree by cos 0 degree. That means 0 divided by 1, 0 divided by 1, that gives us 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2, 1 by 2, if we divide by root 3 by 2, then this 2, 2 will cancel and we will be left with 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3. Then tan 45 degree, tan 45 degree, 1 by root 2, whole thing divided by 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2, that will give us 1. 1 by root 2 and divided by 1 by root 2, they are cancelled. Then tan 60 degree, so sin 60 degree divided by cos 60 degree. That means root 3 by 2, whole thing divided by 1 by 2. So root 3 by 2, whole thing divided by 1 by 2, if we do, then this 2, 2 will cancel and we will be left with root 3 by 1. Root 3 by 1 means simply root 3. And 1 by 0, 1 on dividing by 0, it will become undefined. We cannot divide any number by 0. So it is undefined, for which we can use a symbol called infinity, or undefined, we can read it. So altogether we have got tan 0 degree, 0, tan 30 degree, 1 by root 3, tan 45 degree, 1, tan 60 degree, root 3, and tan 90 degree, it is undefined. Then to get the value of cot, what we did for getting the value of cos, the same technique will apply. That last infinity or undefined symbol that will come in the beginning, and first one will go at last, 0 will go there. Then middle one, this 45 degrees value, it will remain same. Then 60 degrees value, that will become 30 degrees value. So root 3 will come here, and 30 degrees value, tan 30 degrees value, that will become cot 60 degrees value. So it will come here cross. It is 1 by root 3. So altogether we have got here cot 0 degree. Cot 0 degree, it is infinity or undefined. Cot 30 degree, root 3. Cot 45 degree, it is 1. Cot 60 degree, 1 by root 3. Cot 90 degree, 0. Then sec. Sec, it is the reciprocal of cos. Cos reciprocal, if we take, that will give the value of sec. So reciprocal of 1. Reciprocal means interchanging of numerator and denominator. So 1 for this number 1, there is the denominator itself is 1. So 1 by 1, if we interchange, once again we will get 1 by 1. So 1 by 1 means 1 only. So cos 0 degree is 1, and sec 0 degree, that also 1. Then reciprocal of root 3 by 2. Reciprocal of root 3 by 2, that will give us 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3. Reciprocal, just you have to take. Reciprocal of 1 by root 2 is root 2 by 1. Root 2 by 1 means simply root 2. Reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2 by 1. 2 by 1 means 2. And reciprocal of 0. 0 means actually 0 by 1. So when we will do reciprocal, when we will take reciprocal, 0 by 1, it will become 1 by 0. And 1 by 0, once again it becomes undefined, or infinity symbol will come. So to get the value of sec, what we have to do? We have to take the reciprocal of cos. So cos 0 degrees reciprocal will give us sec 0 degrees value. Similarly, to get sec 30 degrees value, we have to take reciprocal of cos 30 degree, sec 45 degree reciprocal of cos 45 degree, sec 60 degree reciprocal of cos 60 degree, and sec 90 degree reciprocal of cos 90 degree. Then to get the last one, cosec 1, again cross we will do. This last value will come at first, and first value, that will go at last. Middle one, that is 45 degrees value, it will remain same, root 2 will remain same in its own place. Then 2, once again if we cross, 2 will come here, and 2 by root 3 will go here. So we get cosec 0 degree. Cosec 0 degree equal to undefined or infinity. Then cosec 30 degree 2, cosec 45 degree root 2, cosec 60 degree 2 by root 3, and cosec 90 degree it is 1. So you can see that if we remember the value of sine, this first 5 values of sine if we remember, then the remaining trigonometric ratios we can find very easily within 30 seconds. Now one problem we will solve based on this table. Suppose our question is evaluate sin 60 degree, sin 60 degree cos 30 degree, then plus sin 30 degree cos 60 degree, sin 30 degree cos 60 degree. Just you have to put the values looking at the table. So if you look at the table, you can see sin 60 degree equal to how much? Sin 0 degree is 0, sin 30 degree half, 0 half, sin 45 degree 1 by root 2, then sin 60 degree it is root 3 by 2. So sin 60 degree it is root 3 by 2 into cos 30 degree. Cos 30 degree how much? It is also root 3 by 2. Let me to write these values again sin for sin. It will help you to understand. So for sin 0 degree is 0, sin 30 degree it is half, 0 half 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2 and 1, 90 degree is 1. So sin 60 degree root 3 by 2, this value I have written, sin 60 degree. Cos 30 degree, if you check the table, we can see it is root 3 by 2, cos 30 degree is value, so root 3 by 2 written, plus sin 30 degree, sin 30 degree how much? Sin 30 degree it is 1 by 2 or half, and cos 60 degree once again it is 1 by 2. Just we have to calculate. If we simplify, that will give us our answer. Now root 3 into root 3, that will give us 3, 2 into 2 4, plus again 1 jar 1 divided by 2 jar 4. LCM will take. Our LCM will be 4. 4 is the LCM. 4 divided by 4 gives 1. 1 into 3, that will give us 3. 3 plus 4 divided by 4 gives 1. 1 into 1, 1. So 3 plus 1, 4 by 4. After cancellation, we'll get 1. So if we know the values, in that case, we can find or we can evaluate this type of problems. In the same way, we'll have to find this type of problems. So thank you for watching our video.